on the righteous side. We turning the world upside down. Ain't a white person, I bet you I could walk up to a white person, ask them if they know they're Edomite, and I bet they'll say yes these days.
Yep.
What, I'm an Edomite now? What, I'm an Edomite? Is that what you were gonna say? I'm an Edomite? You goddamn right, you know now. Guess who did that? Starting with the elders on down. The men who come out here in a revolutionary way and preach the word week in, week out with no fear. I bet you if I say Jake now, you ain't thinking about no goddamn police officer. You been back in the day in the 90s, you say Jake, man. That mean the police, man. That's 12, man. That one time, man. Go ahead.
Right. And sought to bring them out to the people. And when they found them not, they drew Jason and certain brethren unto the rulers of the city, crying, these that have turned the world upside down are come hither also, whom Jason have received, and these all do contrary to the decrees of Caesar.
And that's what you're accusing us of. Now, that's perfect. You can stop right there. That's perfect to go to Romans chapter 13.
I got that.
Okay, bring that out. Start right at the top. And it don't mean what you say it mean, Nate. Because if it meant that, can you find a story? Okay, find a wife.
It's what I think you mean.
Go ahead.
Romans chapter 13, verse 1. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers.
Even you, King Noble. You subject to the higher powers. You paying your phone bill, ain't you, man? You paying your phone bill, ain't you? You paying your rent, ain't you? Unless you homeless. You homeless, man? You got a car, King Noble? If you got a car, you got to pay registration, don't you, King Noble? Don't he got to pay registration? Oh, if he don't got no car, maybe he taking public transportation. Is he hopping a turnstile? Is he hopping a turnstile? He hopping a turnstile and take... Well, I just want you to film all your lawless revolutionary behaviors. That internet you got. I mean, did you just plant a tower for your city? You came up with just like what's this guy? Oh, shut up, you goddamn crackers.
But you only came on Saturday.
Oh, you came on Saturday. Ooga ooga. What's this guy off of the Iron Man, the Russian dude that made the Electro and shit? Did you make your own internet tower, nigga? Or are you paying the mighty, mighty white man? Every month. Go ahead, brother.
Romans 13:1. Let every soul be subject unto the higher power.
Nah, man, he went and he kicked that window down. Boom! Got that computer with the money, then he went back to the went home and revved up his hand crank generator
for all of his electricity.
And pumped his fist in the air and screamed revolution. You fucking asshole, man. Go ahead, man.
For there is no power but of the Most High. The powers that be are ordained of the Most High.
Yeah. And it tells you that in Daniel, that he's the one that sets up the kingdoms of the earth, man. That's in Daniel 2. If you got it, bring it out real quick. Oh, I'm sorry, 4 and 7.
Oh, that's from chapter 2.
Go ahead, brother.
Daniel chapter 4, verse 17. This matter is by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the Holy One.
The spiritual beings in the spirit world. Go ahead.
To the intent that the living may know.
That those of us that are on the earth may know. Go
that
ahead.
The Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men.
He's the one that rules in the kingdom of men. That's why the Lord said what he said. Render unto Caesar what Caesar's, and unto the Lord what's the Lord's. We not gonna be out here doing unreasonable shit, man. The script, the Lord said, wait ye upon me, man. Yep. He said, wait upon him. He also said, vengeance is mine, I will repay, man. So when the time comes, we gonna know. But that's how all revolutions pop off. You know, they got the famous saying, the shot heard around the world. I mean, at a certain point, it's just unavoidable. Trust me, we gonna know when that time is. You gonna know when niggas is coming up to your house trying to take your food and shit. It's party time. You know what I'm saying? I mean, there was a famous general on that, the shot heard around the world. He said, men, wait till you see the whites of their eyes.
Yeah.
And nobody knew who threw the first shot, but the point was, that motherfucking shot rang out, and it was time. Go ahead, brother.
You gotta know when to hold. It's like on Braveheart, where they was setting them dudes up, hold, yep. But it looked like everybody's like, hell no.
Hell no.
Ready to go. But they set them up.
They set their ass up, and if they didn't have it at that right time, them pails wouldn't have got them the way that they got them.
The hell.
Go ahead.
To the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men.
That's right.
And giveth it to whomsoever he will.
So yeah, we live in a society where we gotta follow general rules. As long as those rules don't go against the Most High, then we good. Now, some of those rules or policies do go against the Most High, and necessarily we have to maintain our life. There's certain things, and we're subject to those curses, man. Deuteronomy 28 covers that, man. Should I be eating drinking fluorosilicic acid? Absolutely not. But it apparently is unavoidable.
I ain't got my own water purification
plant. I don't got my own water purification plant and all that other shit, man. I gotta take care of what I gotta take care of, man. And then all the niggas that all of our people that do make it, they not doing shit like that. They not making filters and shit like
man,
that.
Man, I bought this expensive ass motherfucking water thing, man. Yeah, that shit was delicious, right?
Yeah.
And that motherfucker break down every 2 weeks,
every
man.
Every 2 weeks, man.
It got to a point where I'm like, man, fuck this thing, man.
Yep.
You know?
Yep.
I'm just calling these people, having my wife call these people almost every other week trying to fix this goddamn thing, man. Yeah.
We'll be in want of all things,
yeah,
scripture
man, I
saved
up for that motherfucking everything.
That
just shows you we're under these curses, man.
Yeah, so obviously we're going within a reasonable space, do things necessarily to get our daily bread. And the daily bread ain't just money, it ain't just food. It's daily bread literally is just basically like just daily living, getting by, sustaining. Not too much, making it.
Yep. So we're not trying to win in the devil society like y'all, man.
Because the devil society is going down.
Yep.
Just like Paul said, give me that's needful for me.
That's right.
Let me make it.
All right, that's it on that. That's the point. Go ahead, let's go back to that.
Romans chapter 13, verse 2. Whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of the Most High.
Now, when you look up that word resistant, I believe, let's look it up here real quick. It basically means like a coup.
Yeah.
A military coup.
Yeah. And you guys talking all this shit. It's just like when that woman called up, said it at one time, say, man, I got niggas shooting in these going to the range, shooting. I'm ready. Let's do something. You know? Said he wasn't feeling that because he understood. He understood white men will destroy us if we tried to come up against them like that, man.
Yeah, he said every man for himself, man.
And that woman was a dagger. She was a dagger to your whole general SETI idea, man. It's all bullshit.
You ain't no general of shit.
You know?
General, your highness the general of shit.
You know?
Yeah, it's anti-Tasselmeyer. That's what I thought it was. Which means basically like the root of it is 493. Is against Tasselmeyer's like to struggle, oppose,
to
range oneself against. We're not supposed to do that right now.
Yeah.
We're just supposed to live life to the best of our ability and have faith on the Most High, man, that he'll deliver. Go ahead, brother.
Zechariah 4 verse 6. Then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit,
saith the Lord of hosts. I was going to have you read that anyway.
That's right.
That's the, read it again. Call it and read it again.
Zechariah 4 verse 6. Then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts.
That's it. That's it. I mean, you don't even got to break that down.
Yep.
The Lord going to do it, man. But y'all don't believe in the Lord. You're atheists. You believe in bullshit. You believe in your bullshit reason. Let me ask you something about reason. Where did reason come from? What is the origin of it? Can reason just be born out of itself? Can it be born out of itself? No, it cannot. Y'all niggas, y'all claim y'all smart, but y'all don't even understand the whole thing about infinite regression. It can't be no infinite regression. It gotta be a first starter of everything, man.
Go ahead, man.
Right. This is a Sirach 17. I'm gonna start at 1. The Lord created man of the earth and turned him into it again. He gave them few days and a short time and power also over the things therein. He endued them with the strength by themselves and made them according to his image and put the fear of man upon all flesh and gave him dominion over beasts and fowls. They received the use of the five operations of the Lord. And in the sixth...
What are the five operations of the Lord? The five operations of the Lord are your sight, your smell, your taste, your touch, and your hearing, right? That's the five. Now there's a sixth one. Go ahead.
And in the sixth, he imparted them understanding. And the seventh...
Reason!
That's right.
The Lord is the origin of that. Go ahead.
That's why when you see the time that he created man, it wasn't shortly after that there was stuff on the planet.
That's right.
Because they had the reason. They had understanding. But we need to talk to each other.
Let's formulate some language.
We need to do this.
It was the Adamites that when you break it down, it was the Adamites that pretty much were the educated or the enlightened peoples on the planet at the time. So they were imparting all of that to all them Uber motherfuckers.
That's
around,
right.
Man.
That's right.
Wasn't that long for them to be
it didn't take long, man.
You gotta live. You can't ooga booga and just and don't know what the hell is going on for centuries and millennia.
Yeah.
You gonna have to figure this out.
Yeah.
We gotta lead. We gotta live.
Yep.
That's like they say, you can't shit where you eat.
Yeah, you don't shit where you eat.
Yeah.
Adaptation.
Quickly. All right. So it says, they received the use of the five operations of the Lord, and in the sixth place he imparted them understanding, and in the seventh speech and interpretation of the cognitations thereof.
That's right. The ability to understand it. Reason. The cognitation means to know. Cognitive comes from the Greek word gnosis,
yeah.
which means with knowledge, meaning to know. All right, that's the other thing, man. You niggas ain't into them words, man. They hate that
as much as they use.
Nate is into it. He hates it, but he likes to sound like he's fun.
Yeah,
you know,
sophist.
Yeah, he's a sophist. He's a sophist. Not Abraham. Abraham. Family. Man, I hate Seti, man.
Hey, funny to me, though, man. Seti be having me rolling, bro. I be listening to his ass.
Hey, but you can see Sarnetta hate his ass.
Yeah, Sarnetta's tired of that bullshit, man.
Tired of that bullshit, man.
All that talking with no conclusions, man. He got tired of it. Like, these dudes got answers, man. Like, yeah. They got conclusions. They know what's gonna happen. They know what we should do.
And it is happening.
You know?
And it is happening the way the Lord said it was gonna happen. Go ahead.
Counsel and a tongue and eyes, ears, and a heart gave he them.
Oh, wait a minute, but he already gave him the five senses. What type of eyes and ears is he talking about? The ability to hear the truth when you hear it.
That's right.
The ability to see the truth when you see it. To understand, man. If a man, yeah, he didn't have an ear to hear, let him hear. To understand that if a man constantly keeps giving you prophecies and they keep coming to pass, you should listen to that man or to that entity. Go ahead, brother.
Right. He gave them to understand. With all, he filled them with the knowledge of understanding and showed them good and evil.
And that's the point. That's what we read earlier in Ecclesiastes chapter 12. Here's the duty of man. Because at the end of the day, you can know all this shit, but if you don't know the difference between good and evil, you don't know nothing. But see, because see, the Lord is the origin of everything that's set against each other, right? He's the origin of all that. Light can't exist without darkness.
That's right.
Order can't exist without chaos.
Yep.
Go ahead.
He set his eye upon their hearts that he might show them the greatness of his work. Mm. And he gave them to glory in his marvelous acts forever.
And he gave them the glory in his marvelous acts forever. I was going to do a sit down on that. I'm still putting the scriptures together. Just on the magnificence of the Lord, man. Just how magnificent he is, man. Oh, it tells you that in Romans chapter 1, it says, because things that can be known. Let's get that. Get Romans chapter 1 real quick. The things that can be known. Around there, 1 and 17, 1 and 18. Go ahead.
That they might declare his works with understanding.
That you might declare, not with that bullshit.
Yep.
Not with them hieroglyphs that you can't even fucking read. Not with that uniform that your ass can't read. Go ahead, brother.
And the elect shall praise his holy name.
And so right. The people that get it, got it. Got it?
Right.
Good.
Uh-huh. Oh, man.
That's how we got it. We got it good. And since it's understood, hallelujah.
Beside this, he gave them. Beside this, he gave them knowledge and the law of life for an heritage.
That's right.
He made an everlasting covenant with them and showed them his judgment.
That's right. Just like it tell you in Amos 3:7, he showed his servants the prophets his secrets, man.
That's right.
So we understand it. Y'all guys don't get it because, see, you're kicking against the pricks. Really, you guys were pretty much like the last little hurdle of these days and times, man. That pan-African black bullshit.
Yeah.
Y'all are kind of like the last little fizzle-out hurdle. And it was not even a real hurdle. I mean, it was like a, you know, is that, you know, when a, you ever seen them hurdlers, man? Like a real good hurdler that got perfect technique. By the time they hit that third hurdle, they done left everybody behind, man. Uh-huh. They done left everybody. So by the time
they in full stride.
Yeah, by the time you hit that fourth hurdle, you're in full stride. You hit that, you can knock the last hurdle down if you want to.
I ain't gonna even jump, I'm gonna run through this motherfucker.
But y'all in the back hitting all them holes.
Shit.
You know? You stuck on the first thing the white man told you. You stuck on the first thing he told you when you got off that boat.
You fucking African. Get over here.
You stuck on that. You stuck on that.
That's right.
That's the first hurdle.
That's right. That's right.
All
right? Then we give you Deuteronomy 28, and y'all just overlook all that. You know? Y'all don't want to touch that. Was that it on that? It's a whole lot more.
Yeah.
Hold on 1 second. Go ahead, brother.
We just read a little bit more. But that goes into that.
Go ahead, man. Sometimes you got to get all the meat off the bone.
All right. It says, their eyes saw the majesty of his glory, and their ears heard his glorious voice. And he said unto them, beware of all unrighteousness. Mm. And he gave every man.
And so that's what we doing. We aware of y'all, man. And we ain't letting it stand. So y'all come out with y'all bullshit, no matter who you are. If you an Israelite, if you a Baptist, if you a this or that or whatever, a Pan-African, we don't care who you are. If you coming out with that nonsense, and you being wicked, and you ain't promoting righteousness, we gonna stand up against it. We gonna defend the gospel. We gonna defend the gospel, man. That's our duty, that's our job, man. Go ahead, brother. Yeah, that's how she get her extra money. That's a choice. And it didn't look like a Troyan girl. I don't know nothing about the Troyan.
Baby, I don't know what they talking about, baby.
And he said unto them, beware of all unrighteousness, and he gave every man commandment concerning his neighbor. Their ways are ever before him and shall not be hid from his eyes.
See, that's the other thing, too. Y'all not getting away. See, because every idle word you say, every idle act you do, the Lord is he's tabulating that, man. The angels are tabulating that. They bring it back to the Lord, man. You say, well, if the Lord can see everything, why the angels got to tabulate? Everybody got a job to do, man. Everybody got a job to do. And if you understand the magnificence, see, this is the thing that y'all don't understand. And a while back, this was a couple of years ago, me and Elder Tahar were talking about the name of the Lord, and literally it means breathing, man. In and out. He is all in all, man. He's his own entity, but all entities. There's no other entity like that. He's beyond ubiquitous. I mean, he is ubiquitous, but he's beyond ubiquitous. Because when you have omnipresence and you add omnipotence to that, where's the limit of what you can and cannot do? But you and y'all are fighting against that? You fighting against that?
You understand infinity, but you can't recognize that there's a power out there, man. Yep. You can keep counting.
Let me blow your mind with this. The Lord has said everything double against each other, right? Zero and infinity are the same thing. But you want to fight against that.
You act like a white man.
You act just like the goddamn white man. Go ahead.
Yeah. All right.
Their ways are forever before him and shall not be hid from his eyes. Every man from his youth is given to evil, neither could they make to themselves fleshy hearts for stony.
Yeah, we're all under these chains of darkness, so don't get it twisted. We ain't acting like we just always had this, man.
Yep.
It was given to us, but once we got it, we got it. Go ahead.
For in the division of the nations of the whole earth, he set a ruler over every people.
Yep.
But Israel is the Lord's portion.
Go ahead.
But Israel is the Lord's portion.
Israel is the Lord's, man. That's what we're trying to tell you. But you just fighting as hard as hell not to be an Israelite, man. Okay, go ahead. Don't be an Israelite, man. You're going to come back anyway as an Israelite. You ain't going to be a top administrator in Israel, but you're going to come back. Go ahead.
Whom being his firstborn, he nourishes with discipline.
Right. And that also, Israel is the firstborn, man. They say, well, Israel didn't come about until such and such. Israelites when Adam was created, when Adamites were created. Right? Because all that means is prince of the power, the sons of God, the chosen line. That's all Israel means, man. And I'm not trying to trivialize the name. I'm just telling you that that's what it means. Go ahead.
And giving him the light of his love doth not forsake him.
He ain't going to forsake the elect. Because as he read earlier, the elect is the only people that's going to get the full understanding, man. And praise his name. And praise his majesty. Go ahead.
Right.
Therefore, all their works are as the sun before him, and his eyes are continually upon their way.
That's right.
None of their unrighteous deeds are hidden from him, but all of their sins are before the Lord.
That's right.
But the Lord, being gracious and knowing his workmanship, neither left nor forsook them, but spared them.
And that's what we believe, and we believe that. So y'all laughing at us now, but you're going to cry later.
Yep.
You're laughing at us now, but you're going to cry later, man. You got assholes. Nigga, last week, the nigga had his foot all on the brake.
Yeah.
Arch backed out the window like a stripper and shit.
The ghost riding the whip.
Ghost riding the whip. On a green light, talking about we ain't doing nothing. You sound just like King Noble. Yeah. If we not doing nothing, then what you doing?
Less than nothing.
If we not doing nothing, then why the fuck you paying attention to us?
Yep.
Why are we so important to you if we not doing nothing?
Why you ain't making your money?
Right? Why are we so important to you if we not doing nothing? If the debate really is so important to you, why won't you come down for free?
Yep.
Because to me, I'm all about truth. Right. I want to get to the truth of the matter.
Right.
I ain't worried about no goddamn event. That shit take time, man. And then niggas ain't never on time. Shit always disorganized.
You can't even get to
you
the
You can't
end
give
of the bank.
One nigga get, you know, $50, another nigga get $75, they fight in the bank.
So all the equipment was malfunctioning.
Yeah,
you know, the goddamn mic always feeding back and shit.
That's just like when
the projector don't ever work.
Yeah. That's just like when the scripture says,
family, you got the wrong slide up there, family. You got the wrong slide up there, family. Let's go to this one right here. You niggas, don't nobody want, you know, we want truth, man. If it's so, if we so insignificant, then why don't you come down and just deal with us, man?
Because they doctrine is of men, and the scripture say if it's of men, it's going to come to naught, man. That's what I'm saying. We're telling the truth.
Right.
We're telling the truth, whether you believe it, whether you like it or not. You know what I'm saying? We're coming out the Bible. The Bible is telling the truth. We ain't just coming out here just saying stuff. You know what I'm saying? The scripture through the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah, the scriptures give us the blueprint to what's going on.
That's right.
You think we didn't read that you niggas was going to be on that BS? It's in the scriptures that y'all was going to be like that.
Yep.
That's why when it came down to the come down, you didn't stand a chance. Your doctrine don't work. Your way don't work. You know what I'm saying? It ain't no end all be all. It ain't got nothing going. It's just a bunch of this right here. You niggas got two mouths and one ear. And that ear is deaf.
Yeah, you're
right. Sirach chapter 33, verse 2. A wise man hateth not the law, but he that is a hypocrite therein is a ship in a storm.
Yeah, so you a hypocrite within the law, okay?
I'm talking about you want a girl to be twerking and walking around naked and shit. What the fuck is wrong with you, man? What the bloody, I'm going to say it like, hey, this is a shout out to GMS London. What the bloody hell is wrong with you? Bloody hell? What the fuck is wrong with you, man?
I said that world ain't never gonna happen. That world ain't. I would say you wait on a world that ain't coming.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That world ain't coming. I would say you got it now, cause you can handle it in your living room. But that ain't how the world gonna be.
He ain't handling shit.
Yeah.
That's right. Or maybe he is handling shit in his living room. A man of understanding trusteth in the law, and the law is faithful unto him as an oracle. The law is going to be faithful to you. You ain't going to get blown away if you don't sleep with your man's woman.
Right.
Man ain't going to fight you when you get injured if you don't steal from the man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If you don't idolize a bunch of bullshit, bowing down to rocks and shit, you gonna avoid harm.
Just might be alright.
Yeah, you just might be alright because if you don't covet another man's things, then you're not gonna be tempted to steal from it. No. Yeah,
the scripture says
you ain't gonna be tempted to lie to the man to get over on him.
That's right. That's right.
You ain't gonna be tempted to have sex with his wife because your wife is a mud fucking duck. You know what I'm saying? According to the law, what he's reading, the law gonna put that spirit on you because the law gonna be faithful unto you. You're not gonna receive harm if you behave. That's what it goes back to what we were talking about earlier. If you behave properly, which is what y'all not providing for the people.
Go ahead, brother.
Right. This is Sirach 17 and 22. The arms of a man is a signet with him, and he will keep the good deeds of man.
The behavior.
Yep.
The arms of the man. When you walk away, what a brother saying about you, man. Now this goes back to our house, Israel. What a brother saying about you when you walk away, man. Yeah, and I gave that moment of awkward silence for a reason. Give you time to think about this shit.
Go ahead, brother.
As the apple of the eye, and give repentance to his sons and daughters.
And those brothers that are really true brothers, he'll give repentance to them if they, you know, if they mess up from time to time. They may, you know, may come off wrong. May do something unknowingly wicked or may, you know, or even slip up knowing they were doing something wrong, but they just, you know, had a lapse in judgment or something. The Lord will give repentance to those type of men. The Lord ain't gonna give repentance to you niggas. People like King Noble and all that, he ain't giving repentance to you because you're just kicking against the bricks, man.
He turned around.
You ain't took, which is what the word repentance means, right?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
It says, afterward he will rise up and reward them and render their recompense upon their heads.
That's right. Like Shekai. You talking all that shit on the common man, the Lord gonna dust you off. All that stuff you did.
Yeah, man, how about this, man? Go get my car out the pound, bro. Go get my fucking car that you got impounded out the pound, man. How about that, nigga? That you fucked up.
How about the fact that Wamba got a picture of you in the mail with a do-rag going out the window getting caught running red lights?
Yeah,
man.
And somebody else shit multiple times. How about that, man? Don't
shit.
Make us air you out, bro.
Oh, yeah. Stop it. Stop
don't
while
you
ahead.
Don't make us air you out.
Stop while you ahead, man.
All right.
How about the fact that you really, really like pizza?
All right.
Shall we discuss jumbo shrimp, nigga?
So living rice?
Yeah, living
yeah.
rice.
Just yeah.
Like, you know, you got Mexican jumping beans. This nigga had Israelite jumping ones. You piece of shit. You don't make us air you out, man.
Oh, man.
You piece of shit.
Yeah,
man. Oh, man.
Don't
bring
it up.
God damn.
You're a piece of shit, man. You're a piece of shit, man. You wash your clothes in the goddamn dishwasher.
Come on, man.
Now you know who you're dealing with, bro. Come on, man.
Yeah, stop that shit.
This brother, man, he set up one time because we was debating about whether to kick him out the camera. And you know me, I had my bubbles already getting a nigga out of here. Cause he's just wicked, man. He would not stop. But we started thinking about, you know, the brother trying to, man, this brother brought out so much shit he did that I forgot. I was just like, oh, I forgot he did that shit. Oh, I forgot that too.
That lets you know he doing too much. You doing enough shit to people to forget about.
Yeah.
Because you know me, once I squash it with a person, I squash it. All these brothers know me.
Right.
I'll get in your ass about something. But once we squash it, it's done with me. You
right.
know what I'm saying? Let's move on to the next thing.
How about the fact we had to beg you to buy your own soap, nigga?
Yeah.
You dirty piece of shit, you. She got you to kiss my ass.
He don't buy towels because he aired her, right?
You don't buy towels.
It's somebody else.
Wamba was coming home. He was calling me and she said, man, this motherfucker leaving my goddamn, he leaving puddles and shit on the goddamn bathroom floor, man. How about the fact that we had to beg your ass for about goddamn 6 months to buy a goddamn shower curtain, you dirty fuck? You piece of shit, you. Taking weed brownies on an airplane,
Lord,
nigga.
Oh, man.
How about you fell in love with a goddamn prostitute? Do you want me to? I can keep going, nigga. Stay off our goddamn comic board, man. Yeah. If you wanna address me, because really your problem is with me, man. If you wanna address me, you know where I'm at, nigga. And when you came down here last time, I looked you dead. How about the fact that you took this man's car to a baby that nobody knew about, man? And then the spirit alerted. Is the spirit alerted, brothers? And you had a goddamn helium mouth, nigga. With helium balloons all over the goddamn plate.
I'm just gonna tell. Yeah, I'm just gonna have the hand and everything.
How about that? And then when you came down here, I looked you right in your face. I said, "Get the fuck out of here, nigga."
Dog, you just
you a wicked, you a liar, man. You a liar, man. How about the fact that you tried to sneak in front of everybody on the Sabbath in front of the TV?
In front of a Hashitashi 5000.
Hey, and we haven't even got to 1/4.
Well, hold up. Me and this bro, where's CJ? Where's the car at?
They're gonna say
me and this brother. We said it out loud. We said, bro, we see you.
Yeah,
we see you.
Yeah, the Yankees played it in front of the biggest TV in the world, trying to slide by there.
We gave this dude so much, bro. We moved him out of his mama's crib. Clothes on his back, a car.
Taught him how to spit game.
Taught him how to go get the nice girls uptown instead of the ratchet.
But then what you do? You brought us a whole bunch of goddamn mud ducks.
With the Christmas light ponytail. Yeah, the Tootsie Roll size ponytail.
Man, don't make us think you out, man. You're something else, man. Go ahead, man.
There's the devil.
Like,
I really ain't a
problem. It says, but to them that repent, he granted them return and comforted those that fell in patience. Return unto the Lord and forsake thy sins. Make thy prayer before his face and offend less.
And offend less. That's what you should be doing, Shakat.
Offend less?
That's what you should be doing, Shakat. Offend less. You should be worrying about not sinning, man. You should be worried about
definition of a sin?
It says,
I don't have a definition of sin. The Lord has a definition of sin.
What's the Lord's definition of a sin?
Breaking the law, breaking the commandments. Let's read it for him.
Hey, I'm trying to be nice tonight, man. Can we get along tonight?
I'm being nice.
Can we get along tonight?
Second John.
Yeah, 2 John 6 for the men.
He got it right.
Oh, that's cool. I'm not trying to.
1 John 3.
Okay,
I got it.
You got it.
Okay, bring it out.
1 John 3:4. Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law.
That's what sin is. That's the definition of sin. When you transgress the law, you're sinning.
What does that mean?
The law. It's a law not to commit adultery. You don't sleep with another man's woman. It's a law not to steal. You don't steal. It's a law not to murder. You don't murder.
I understand.
It's a law. Okay, so that's the definition.
Right. Like if you do those things, then you're sinning.
Okay.
You're transgressing the law. You're going against the
transgressing
law.
Means going across the law. You're crossing the line.
Okay.
You're crossing the line.
So that's okay.
All right. But why does it have to be the white man that's so evil?
Edomites. It's Edomite. Because look what the white man has done.
I don't know, man.
Look what the so-called white man has done.
I know, but you can't blame the rest of us.
Yes,
white
I can.
Man. I don't think so, man.
Yes, I can.
Because we weren't the white men that did that, man.
Okay, so then why don't you people that... Okay, so if you're the descendants of the people that did that, don't you think that...
That don't make it
listen,
my fault, though,
listen,
man.
Listen. Okay. Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question. Do you believe in justice?
Okay, hold on.
All right. Let's say your father... We ain't talking about a lot of generations. Let's just say your father went, right?
I don't like my father.
Okay, whatever. Just say you were in good standing with your father.
Okay.
Right? Or not. It doesn't matter.
Right.
Okay, just follow me, all right? Follow the logic.
I'm listening.
Your father...
I'm not following. I'm listening.
Well, you know what I mean when I say father. I'm not saying the father.
Okay, all right, all right.
Your father, he goes out and he mutilates a whole family a couple of miles down, takes all their riches and all their goods. He comes back home and he says, son, we're in the money.
Made it.
We're in the money.
We're in the money.
Right?
I know the song.
All right, so, but and you accept it. Hold on.
Because that's my father and that's what I was
told. Hold on. Follow the logic. And you accept it, knowing full well how he got it.
No, I was too young.
Hold on, but okay, that's fine. But you know full well how he got it.
When you grew up.
Now, the person's family son.
I agree with
listen,
you.
Listen. Okay. The person's son, who he did that to, he comes up and he says, excuse me, sir. Many years ago, your father came to my household and took this, 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 this. He gives you an inventory, right? He says, I would like those things back because that belongs to my family. And you say, I didn't do it. These things are mine now.
No.
That's what you just said.
I didn't say they were mine now. They're still my father.
But that's what we're trying to tell you. Let's say your father's dead. And now these things are in your possession.
I would give them back.
Okay, then that's what we're saying. You took this land. You're going to be forced to
give it. I didn't take it, though.
Your fathers did.
I understand
that. They took this land from our people. They mutilated us. They murdered us. They promised us things that they never gave us. And you people sit and you benefit from it. And you're not trying to give it back.
As a nation, you act like I've got all the authority.
Okay, bring it out.
To give it back.
Okay, yes, you do. Yes, you do.
Myself?
You have authority to... All white people have authority to do whatever they want on the earth. If y'all got together, if a goddamn white man sit on a press conference today, the leader of the new world, Bill Clinton, I believe today, us white people need to be held accountable for the things that we've done on the earth. We are going to give all the cobalt and the gold back to the Africa.
I was just wondering.
We're going to give all the ivory to the West Africa.
We're
going to give all of the spices.
I came with open mind today, man. You know.
Get ready for judgment.
He can do that. Go ahead, brother.
Surah 41 and 6. The inheritance of sinners' children shall perish, and their prosperity shall have a perpetual reproach.
And your prosperity. Will have posterity, meaning the children, shall have a perpetual reproach. So that's why we have a reproach towards you. Go ahead.
The children will complain of an ungodly father.
And you complaining of an ungodly father. I didn't do it. I didn't do it. It wasn't me sounding like Shaggy and shit. It wasn't me.
Because they shall be reproached for his sake.
Because they're going to be reproached for his sake. So it says the children will complain of an ungodly father because they are going to be reproached for his sake.
That's right.
And that's what's happening, man. That's what's happening, man. The children of those ungodly fathers are being reproached.
Yep.
And the Most High has prescribed that the benefits of those children is going to be forcibly taken away.
Yep.
Harshly procured.
Brutally. Yep.
Was it beautifully?
Beautifully.
Make a new word.
Beautifully, we're going to make booty of your nation. That's right. You're going to be spoiled.
Yeah.
Beautifully, we're going to make booty.
I'm going to jump down and
yeah,
die.
You get to keep all the ugly white
about.
Women.
Do
you know what? You never heard of booty?
You never heard of booty? I mean, there's booty, and then there's booty, like sunken treasures.
Yeah. That's what we're talking about.
That's what we're talking about.
Booty.
Which one?
Booty is not sunken treasures. It's plunder.
Yes.
No, I don't know, man.
Verse 9.
I'm heading home, man.
And if you be born, you shall be born to a curse. And if you die, a curse shall be your portion.
That's right.
A curse is going to be your portion.
And what does that mean, if you die, a curse will be your portion? When you come back, you're coming right back into slavery, man. You ain't going to get no ease. Because when you up in the spirit world, you're going to know. Shit.
Most high going to see you in the spirit.
No!
Well, I say it happened to us.
Yeah, I was just about to say that.
Well, I say it happened to us, and it's going to happen to y'all.
And the proof that it happened to us is in Revelation.
Yeah.
Because in Revelation, we're in the spirit world constantly crying to the Lord.
Right.
Because every time we go back, man, we suffering, man. Yeah,
my son, that dude hates this place, man. He hated this place in the womb. He gave my wife hell ever since his conception, man. And he's still that way, man. He's like, this is some bullshit. I don't like this motherfucking place, man. This food sucks. This house sucks. This place, they don't like people. And y'all know my wife, she's the most like, that shit don't work with him, man. The only person he'll listen to is me. That's it. That's it. You know?
Okay, no, let him bring this out real quick.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 21. Prepare slaughter for his children, for the iniquities of their fathers.
Right. You so-called, well, you're not getting out of it, man.
Nope.
Bottom line is you ain't getting out of it. You other nations, too. Sometimes you forget to bring out your other nations. You Elamite, because I'm reading this book. It's like the third time I've read it, but I'm doing a refresher, the history of the Peloponnesian War. Them other nations was putting us in hell too, man. Goddamn Cushites, we gonna get your ass too, man. We gonna take your women.
Yep.
You Elamites, you East Indians and Persians and so on and so, we gonna get your ass too. We gonna get you, man. You Egyptians. Hey, just to show you how much better we were than you guys, look at Manute Bol, man. That nigga was whack. All he was tall, man. Shaq was punishing that dude.
I said, look how he did Mutombo ass.
And just in case y'all niggas want to get stupid, Olajuwon is a G.
Yeah, that's right.
It ain't even that. He's just the reason he comes from, he's a G, man. Olajuwon was brutalizing that motherfucker, man.
Paul's all in the stern.
Hell yeah, he teaching LeBron how to work. Go ahead, brother.
That they do not rise nor possess the land, nor fill the face of the world with cities.
That's all you so-called white people, man. Now I just gave him a perfect scenario. He admitted that he should give it back, but now when you do it on a grander scale, all of a sudden it's irrelevant. It's invalid.
Right.
But that goes to show you how wicked and evil and deceptive you so-called white people are.
That's just your nature. Prideful.
That's your nature. You're evil. You're a bunch of liars. You're deceptive.
Yep.
Go ahead. Yeah, y'all. Matter of fact, y'all go ahead, bro. I said, you know, I pretty much laid out what I wanted to say today. I mean, you know, if the spirit hit me, I'll say more. But I mean, that's. At the end of the day, man, the magnificence of the Lord is always going to overpower anything that y'all can bring up against the truth, man. You know?
Hey, that's why you niggas, going back to you niggas, you was just getting on, you know, you with your little Black Power movement, you niggas don't even realize that you're under the curses written in the Bible that you're preaching against, or that you speak out against. And there ain't nothing you can do to get up out of those curses. That's why somebody get Deuteronomy 28, start at 15. Probably gonna get a whole lot of these curses. There's one curse in particular that says you're gonna be the Lord's gonna send cursing and vexation on everything that thou put his hand to do.
Right.
The second that you spoke out against the men of the Lord, the next couple days, day, two or later, however many it was. Now you on the phone cursing each other out. You Sarnetta and Seti. Yeah, y'all on the phone talking shit and all that, mad at each other. Seti supposedly didn't live up to his expectations. That's because you spent your whole time going up against all these other random philosophies, and then you came up to the truth. That was it.
You got beat down like
that. Right. You got your ass.
That's right. Titus.
You use every excuse to prove as to why you didn't win that debate. It's not necessarily a win or loss. You just didn't have the truth. and the truth overshadowed all that bullshit that you was talking about.
Right, that's right.
Hey, somebody get First Ezra, it's the fourth, it says,
but, you trying to blame it on the camera, you trying to blame it on the lighting in the room, you trying to blame it on the drums in the back, but it had nothing to do with that, so you ain't got no reason to be mad at Sonnetta or like that.
Right. Yeah, just like I was going to say, sound, the scriptures say in Titus that sound doctrine, it won't be kept down by gangsters, man, and that's going to what that brother's saying. You ran into sound doctrine, the truth. And it can't be gangsaved by you niggas, man. And that's why y'all look so bad, because y'all were confounded, man.
That's right.
Y'all confounded on y'all bullshit. And now y'all scrambling around like a fucking waiter that got his fucking his old plate tossed in the air, man. Yeah, dishes and all y'all shit broken on the ground, man.
It's like Canelo, Canelo just had Mayweather beat the hell out of Canelo not too long ago. He's going through all these other fighters, good fighters.
Right.
Whooping their ass, and then he came up against Mayweather.
That's right.
Nope. Nope. Jab your ass. There was not one answer that you could bring, or so-called answer that you could bring that was going to prove any points you had. You were just up there looking foolish.
Right.
White did it. Said he did it. All right. And you were going up against some ISUPK and some other random sect of Israel.
Yeah.
Had you gone up against the elders up in New York? Man, that wouldn't have made it on. It probably wouldn't have made it on the internet. Although it probably would have. It wouldn't have been on the debate.
Oh, they would have edited it.
Go ahead, bro. You got that first edge.
First edge was 4:38. As for the truth,
what is the truth? The scriptures, the Holy Bible. Go ahead.
It endured.
It endured. That means the truth has been enduring since the beginning of time. Since prophets were called seers.
Yeah.
All right. Since Adam, all the way till now, the truth. This book. And all the whole totality of this book and the knowledge of Yahweh Shem Yahushua has endured. Go ahead.
I'm starting at 37.
Go ahead.
First Ezra 4:37. Lion is wicked. The king is wicked.
Yep.
Women are wicked.
Hey, if you want to parade all your women around and have them walk around naked, go ahead. If you want some kind of kingdom like that, they're gonna be popping, getting popped every damn thing. It's going to be a filthy kingdom. It's going to be infested with wickedness. Women are wicked. Go ahead.
All the children of men are wicked.
Mm-hmm.
And
the children of men, them Hamites, them Africans, those are the children of men. Those aren't the children of the power.
That's right.
So you want to be a nation of wicked ass people? Go ahead. All right, go ahead.
And such are all their wicked works. And there is no truth in them.
No truth in them. So how you say that the universe and the stars and the planets was created, how you say that the black woman is God, all that, there's no truth in any of that. It's all just for you basically to get at women. And they just said that women are wicked. All that is for you to make you look good so you can sound profound and impress some damn body. All right? And the men of the Lord, the elect, that are out there, they ain't gonna be impressed nor deceived by that bullshit. Go ahead.
In their unrighteousness also they shall perish. As for the truth, it endureth.
The truth endureth, go ahead.
And is always strong. It liveth and conquereth forevermore.
It liveth and conquereth forevermore. So somebody get real quick, 1 Corinthians, was it 10? The weapons of our warfare are not carnal? I believe it's 1 Corinthians 10, or is it 2 Corinthians 10? Yeah. Read that part one more time about the Bible where it says conquer.
First Ezra 4:38. As for the truth, it endureth and is always strong. It liveth and conquereth forevermore.
It liveth and conquereth. And the truth liveth. The scripture says that these words are living waters, like Prophet Dash just said. And those living waters conquer all other imaginations and philosophies out there. Should be able to stack
that
somebody hold that. Bro, you got that in
your
article? Oh, you got it.
Got it.
Whoever's 20,
y'all.
Go ahead.
2 Corinthians chapter 10, starting at verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh.
Yep.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Weapons of our warfare are not carnal. So, hey, that's another cut to you trying to say you got to be out, go out and be revolutionary. And take down this so-called white man. We ain't gonna do that. The scriptures say that the weapons of our warfare aren't carnal. But what are they? Go ahead.
But mighty through the Most High.
Our weapons are spiritual. All right, we're swinging spiritual swords. We're firing spiritual bullets at you. All right, through this knowledge. Go ahead.
To the pulling down of strongholds.
The pulling down of strongholds. That means when you you come up with that, man, you say that you're African, atheist, you're a Roman Catholic, you're a Muslim, all right? You're a so-called Jew, you're a
Christian. Seventh Day Adventist.
Anybody, Seventh Day Adventist, anybody that has come up against GMS, all right, since they came up on YouTube, guess what? All that's been pulled down by this word.
That's right.
It's come to naught. They all fade and just fall the hell out. Go ahead.
Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of the Most High.
And you clowns are the perfect example of a high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of the Most High. You say that the Bible was plagiarized. You said that the people in the book did not exist. All right, the Hebrews.
They were,
all right?
They were white men.
The Bible ain't real. All right, you say all that stuff. And you're trying to exalt your own pro-African doctrine against the knowledge of the Most High. And it was a big-ass mistake. All right? It was a big-ass mistake, because now look at you. You're looking real foolish.
And yeah. Bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of HaMashiach.
Yeah, bringing into captivity every thought unto the obedience of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua.
And having in a readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled.
Yep, now go ahead.
Isaiah chapter 54, verse 17. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper.
No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. So nothing that you have to say on a spiritual level, nothing you have to say is going to prosper, all right, against this truth. If it's coming up against these scriptures, it ain't going to prosper.
That's right.
It don't matter how grand you try to make it sound, how profound you try to sound.
That's right.
It's not going to fly, all right? Go ahead.
And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment.
Wait. Every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, all right? Bobalai and forgot these niggas existed, but the High Time Show.
Right.
Comfy, wherever the hell he is, ISUPK.
Iguana.
Yeah, the General Iguana. All right, man. Nate, the IUIC.
Yep.
They all have one thing in common. They all come up against the men of the Lord. Starting with the elders, starting with Elder Tahar.
And all them different groups that brother just named off, all of them got different doctrines.
Every single
And they
one.
Never get into it with each other.
Nope.
You ain't gonna see Johanna go ahead, Nate. That's what I'm saying. One of them saying the chip is this, one of them saying the chip is that. They don't argue about that. But they both agree that the mark of the beast ain't the chip.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Go ahead, bro. Yeah, the brothers Bumbleite believe in mermaids and fallen angels and the planets.
And the chip.
And the chip. But then the iguana. Say you can do it in the butt.
They say faith-based Israelites.
Yeah, faith-based Israelites.
Come on,
that you wrong for being a faith-based Israelite.
He mocked the name of the Lord.
He mocked the name of the Lord. And this nigga saying that the planets are falling angels and they're mermaids. This other nigga saying the black woman is God.
Don't forget that Bartholomew gland.
And don't forget the Bartholomew gland. Alright? All that. They ain't going against each other. They going against the elder, the GM, great millstone.
The truth.
The truth.
They going against the truth.
Yeah, and it endures above all things. All right, go ahead.
But if I could say this, they were doing debates against each other, right?
Right.
Before, that's how the whole debate thing came up. Because when SETI did a debate with Polite, he brought out all that same shit about Malachi.
You were fighting.
Exactly. But now that the truth is coming to picture, all those groups, they're all lined up against you.
Yep. They like, oh, hold on. Let's get these. Who are these people?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, like the brother had the scripture read earlier. These men to turn the world upside down. They saw the GMS pop up. Who are these niggas? Nah, hell no. Hey, like Demetrius in Acts 19, when Paul came up and he saw Paul doing everything and preaching the gospel. He said, hold up, man, this dude's gonna mess my money up.
Hold up, bro.
I'm making all these idols to Diana in Ephesus.
And he brought all the people up.
Yeah, and he got all the people. Yeah, we getting this money. who was this nigga coming along turning this my money up?
That's why they killed the Lord.
That's
the same reason.
Yep. Hey, they said that if it's, they said if the Lord if we don't, I forget how it's worded, but basically it said that if we don't let, if we don't stop this man, speaking about Yahweh Shai, that the Romans would come and take away our place, that nation.
That's right.
They had a higher place than them wicked Pharisees and Sadducees.
And all the sacrificing was stopping the temple.
Yep.
So all that, that's out the door.
Yep.
So they was like, nah, we gotta kill that dude.
Yep. Same thing. It comes all back to this day and age, right?
That's right.
As soon as the Lord comes to his prophets, all right, you all basically zero in on them men. But guess what? We just read that again, and I go back to Isaiah. Even though you come with all your hundreds and thousands of damn philosophies and doctrines and new, all the bullshit you believe in, guess what?
Go ahead, bro. It says, no weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper.
But ain't none of that gonna prosper. Hey, it's all gonna get cut down. It's all gonna get dissected. You're gonna get mocked. There's gonna be videos go up on you, how stupid you look. All right, and in this day and age, it don't take long for a video to go viral. All right?
Lord, just thump that shit away.
Yep.
And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, Thou shalt condemn.
That's why we out here and we come up against it, because we're supposed to. We're supposed to condemn you people through the word. All right? We won't let you make it. We'll let you just slide. If you out there preaching some kind of doctrine that is contrary to the will of the Heavenly Father, guess what? It's going to get spoken out against. If that video pops up on YouTube and somebody sees it, guess what? It's going to get spoken out against.
That's right.
You got something wrong here?
Everybody focus their attention because I'm last.
1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 9. Where I think that the Most High has set forth us the apostles last.
Most High has set forth us the apostles last in these latter days. Alright, somebody get, was it 1 Timothy, the 3rd chapter?
I got it.
I believe 2 Timothy, in the last days, you know, there's going to be scholars. Read that again.
That's Peter.
Or it's the
2 Peter. Yes, sir. Yeah, that's it.
For I think that the Most High has set forth us the apostles last.
The apostles last, all right? In these last days, and if you can't tell that these are the last days, you are a blind fool. If you can't tell that there's all the signs are here. There's wars, there's rumors of wars, wickedness is at an all-time high. There's 7 billion people on the planet, all right? All these prophecies are coming to fruition, all right, about the end time. People are having fun and eating and drinking. We're in the last days. And guess what, Con? Guess what? The apostles, which are the prophets, are going to be here to condemn all that. What?
As it were appointed to death, for we are made a spectacle unto the world.
Wait, we're made a spectacle unto the world. What does it mean to be made a spectacle? It means to spectate. It means you're seeing, you're watching. So the whole world is watching the prophets. That's why it's no wonder there's a media blackout against the real men of the Lord, whether it be on the news, whether it be on YouTube. You ain't gonna see too many other news media outlets that's gonna be covering the real prophets, because it's gonna be too controversial. Alright? Sooner or later, you ain't gonna be able to keep the word from getting out, though. As far as the big media, all the media and all that. Sooner or later, you ain't gonna be able to do shit to stop it.
Yep.
Because all the words and all the prophecies that are mentioned in this book, we're out here speaking, they're gonna be coming to pass. And you're gonna be looking for answers for the same men you call crazy. Like on the movie 2012, you realize that them crazy ass men on the corners where signs were right, that's what you're gonna realize. Them crazy ass men with garments and signs and a 12 tribe sign and a camera, all right, they're gonna be the ones that were telling the truth the whole time.
Are they still on it? They in production now. They still in production now. Yeah, they got it. Yeah.
No, they're working on it.
For we are made a spectacle unto the world, and to angels and to men.
And we're made a spectacle unto the world, unto angels and unto men. So everybody is watching us. All right, the prophets. So we gonna speak with the. Gonna speak the words that the prophet is supposed to speak. Go ahead,
Isaiah 30 and 20.
And though the Lord give you bread of adversity and water of affliction,
means the Lord's going to put his men, his elect, through hell. Go ahead.
That's right.
Yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore.
The teachers ain't going to be removed into a corner anymore. But what's going to happen? Go ahead.
But thine eyes shall see thy teachers.
Thine eyes shall see thy teachers. So there's going to be people watching. Whether it be on the net, whether they be passing by, whether it be walking and driving by, all right, or across the street in the apartment, or wherever other brothers is at, guess what? Your eyes are going to see your teachers. Go ahead.
That was it. Well, you keep going.
Yeah.
That's what. And thine ears shall hear a word behind thee saying, this is the way, walk ye in it.
And that's how brothers is going to get sealed. All right? That's how it happened to all of us. You're sitting on YouTube looking for answers, and it just so happens that the elders popped up. All right? And at the time, they were, I'll be honest, at the time, I thought they looked crazy. I said, what the hell are they? They cursing and mad. They chased. I remember the America, it was like 30-part series. America's accounts will be permanently deleted. I remember they were cursing for error. Elder tells the doc about chasing a nigga up the street talking about Jesus. I remember that shit. That's how it happened. Every brother got a similar story. They were cursing, they were mad, they were angry, they had beards, and they had the garb. We didn't know what these were, but you just, let me keep watching.
And that's and the thing about it, just like Paul said, he sent forth the apostles last. I seen that after I seen everything else. I seen the bugs and the Bible Center and all that. And then when I said the first video I seen was the history of the world is contained in the Bible. And it was like a 30-part series. Yeah. I'm talking about they was going through everything. They went through the history of the whole world. Yep. You know what I'm saying? But the point is, when we saw them videos, that was after we had seen everything else. Because the scriptures tell you that Jacob is looking for something, but the election have obtained it. You know what I'm saying? We don't got to get it, but that's what I'm saying. The whole time, before the elect had obtained it, you was always looking. Is it this? That Muslim shit? Oh, nah, hell nah. You know what I'm saying? Certain things that'll turn you off. With all these different religions, it was always something that turns you off. But when it came to this truth, when you seen that on YouTube, when you seen the videos, you stuck. And it made sense.
Yep.
That was the first thing that made sense. You know what I'm saying? You got brothers that been looking for their whole life on something that makes sense. And all that stuff that don't make sense, don't make sense.
Makes sense. Yep. Hey, I bought a Quran back in the day. I'm about to get into this motherfucker.
Because it didn't make sense.
I'm not wrong. I cracked it open. That's it.
This ain't it. Seventh-day Adventist, that ain't it.
Oh.
Pentecostal, that ain't it. Oh. Baptist, that ain't it. You know, 5%, that ain't it. Egyptology, that ain't it.
But then you watch a YouTube video. Yeah. Hold on. Don't I got a Bible in my house? Dust off of it, you start looking, it's Deuteronomy 20. Hold up, why the fuck did my pastor read this to me?
Right.
Read that? Wait a minute. We gonna come up, this is an Egypt? The Lord hates?
Jesus,
what?
Jesus,
why
is a black dude?
Why are these niggas singing about that church the Lord hates?
Hold on. And then on top of that, if you go to the Hebrew say this.
Yeah.
You go back to the Hebrew and it's saying. Yeah. Come on, man. Hebrew?
My pastor ain't never tell me no damn Hebrew.
You gonna tell me the truth in English, Greek, Latin, Hebrew? Yeah, the truth stand above all
that.
No matter what language it's in, it's the truth. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. You got something. You finished that.
Isaiah 30:21, and thine ears shall hear a word behind thee saying, this is the way, walk ye in it.
Yeah, this is the way, walk ye in it. So we know, if you're the elect, the Lord say, hey, look, I know you've been looking, you bought a Quran, you had a kufi and beads, and you was in church. Before that, you was smoking weed. Hold on, wait a minute, I'm gonna say it again, Deuteronomy 28, something about that is resonating. Something about that, I don't like getting for something, let me stop, either let me stop here and listen to these dudes talk, or let me, if I'm in front of my computer, let me crack a Bible open, or let me go pull it up on the internet, and let me listen to what they got to say. Something about it is resonating.
All right, I ain't never heard nothing like this. All right, you get y'all, you clowns with your little Pan African bullshit. Y'all can't say that, cause all you doing is just making money and trying to impress people. This truth is about the Lord said we ought to go to the 12 tribes of Israel and seal up the elect through the word. All right, that's it. All right, I'm gonna make, not to make it sound small, but that's our job.
You got a job. All
right. Not to impress no damn body, but to preach the word. Be instant, in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke,
I got a
absorb
quick
with all long-suffering. All right, go ahead. Let my spot finish.
When ye turn to the right hand, and when ye turn to the left.
That's it.
Read that again. Read that part again, the last part.
When ye turn to the right hand, and when ye turn to the left.
Yep, when you turn to the right or the left, no matter which direction you go, once you hear that truth, that's it. Once you hear that truth, that's it. If you're the elect, they ain't nothing you gonna be able to. Jonah tried to run. He tried to run to Tarshish. He said, "Oh man, I'm about to get on the ship." And most of us like, "No, you're not."
I said, "Jeremiah tried to make it to you."
Yeah, he said, "I'm too young." Moses said, "I can't speak eloquently." Jeremiah said, "I'm too young." Jonah took off running. That fish was like, "Oh, look."
It's crazy.
First of all, we're going to toss you off. These mariners are going to toss you off the ship. And then there's going to be a fish waiting on you. Swim you all the way back over here and vomit you up. Now go preach. Go ahead, Zachary.
Psalms 40 and 8. I delight to do thy will, O my God.
Yep.
O my power. Yea, thy law is within my heart.
Can you read verse 7?
Okay. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me.
Yeah, the testimony of Yahweh Shai, which is prophecy, comes in. He comes in the whole volume of the book. Hey, that's for you. Thank you. You and Oath, for you clowns saying that you don't need the Old Testament or you don't need the New Testament. No, you need but the whole book. All right? Go ahead, bro.
I delight to do thy will, O my power.
Yep.
Yea, thy law is within my heart.
Yeah, I delight to do thy will. Alright, what is the Lord's will? To come out here and prophesy? Come out here and condemn these people? Come out here to wake up the elect? Alright? Make your body a living sacrifice? That's the will of the Lord. Go ahead.
I have preached righteousness in the congregation. Lo, I have not refrained my lips, O Lord, thou knowest.
Yep, I have not refrained my lips. So we're giving you everything that we can give, all right? Everything is contained in this Bible. Guess
freely.
What? Yeah, freely. We ain't had no event. What's the name of the American? It's the American Airlines. We ain't gone. We got tickets for $50. All right, we'll get you a free beer and some nachos or something. You come down and sit, and you can enjoy this.
Extravaganza.
Oratation, that's the best word I can think of. Lecture, there you go. You can enjoy this lecture. All right? No, we come out to the highways and the byways, all right, in the main place of concourse, all right, and we preach and we prophesy.
For free.
For free. Hey, the scripture says we're freely given, so freely give. Go ahead.
Verse 10, I have not hid thy righteousness within my heart. I
ain't hid the righteousness, all right? We come out here and give you the whole, we give you it all. Cover to cover, go ahead.
I have declared thy faithfulness and thy salvation. I have not concealed thy loving kindness and thy truth from the great congregation.
Well, we ain't concealed the truth. Who's the great congregation? The nation of Israel. We ain't concealed the truth from them. The elect of the nation of Israel. All right? There ain't nothing to hide in this book. We give you everything. And we ain't hitting no corners. And you see in your teachers. All right?
So you giving them everything from the old to the new and the whole book, right? I'll finish off on this.
This is Matthew 13 and 52. Then said he unto thee, therefore every scribe which is instructed unto the kingdom of heaven.
Stop real quick. Before you continue, somebody get Romans 11, verse 33. Read it real quick. Let's go straight to 28. All right?
Romans chapter 11, verse 33. Okay. Oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of the Most High.
Yep.
How unsearchable are his judgments, and his ways past finding out.
So we've established that the knowledge of the Most High are riches, all right? It's the depth of the riches. This is the deep knowledge, all right? These are the riches. Now go ahead, Monsipar.
Matthew 13:52, then said he unto them, therefore every scribe which is instructed unto the kingdom of heaven is like unto a man that is an householder, which bringeth forth out of his treasure things new and old.
Bringeth forth out of his treasure, that's another word for riches, treasure. But bringeth forth out of his treasure things new and old. So you gotta have the Old and New Testament, right? Then you gotta have the Apocrypha in there too. Alright? You gotta have the whole Bible. When the Lord gave Daniel and John the book in the vision, he said, take this book. He didn't have the book. He said, here, take half the book. He said, oh, take this whole book and eat that I give thee. Not literally eat it, just eat the whole roll. Get all this knowledge, 100%, right?
That's just like in 1 Maccabees chapter 9, it says that we got the Holy Scriptures to comfort us. Let's talk about all of them. I want to say, when you talk about the Holy Scriptures, you talk about all of them. The first, the Old Testament, the New Testament, the Apocrypha, all that, it all go together, man. You can't pick and choose which half fits you the best, because all of them is in agreement with each other.
Yep.
So if you don't believe in the New Testament, you don't believe in the Old Testament.
Yep.
If you don't believe in the Old Testament, you don't believe in the Apocrypha.
Yep.
Stop all that tap dancing shit. Nah, man, you either gonna learn the whole thing or you not, man. You know what I'm saying? You ain't set up to do that.
Yep. Bottom line, the truth, like we had the brother read 1 Ezra's earlier, the 4th chapter. Bottom line, the truth is gonna reign supreme over everything, point blank, period. Right? Until the end of this time and throughout all of eternity.
That's right.
All
right?
The truth is gonna reign supreme. All right? You know, maybe brother's got
any other. That's it.
This is Acts chapter 5 verse 38. And now I say unto you, refrain from these men.
Yeah, this is what you niggas should have did. You should have left the men of the Lord alone. You in your own little world, you were looking good until you came and messed with the men of the Lord.
Right.
Now you looking all discombobulated. Go ahead.
And now I say unto you.
I told you, but you didn't want to hurt me. Yeah. I tried.
I was watching this movie on Netflix with Tom Cruise. And right before he whooped this dude's ass, he told him, he said, remember, you wanted this.
Oh, that's Jack Reacher. He told him, his face said, look, I'm going to punch the leader. You beat up the leader. And then the two guys might be kind of ballsy. And then the last two just run off. Yeah, he says, remember, you wanted this. He whooped their ass. He beat their ass. And he told them exactly what was going to happen. Hey, the Lord told you what was going to happen in the end days.
Yes, sir.
All right?
The end game.
The Lord told you what was going to happen. Go ahead.
Refrain from these men and let them alone.
Yep.
For if this counsel or this work be of men, it will come to naught.
If the counsel or this work be of men, it will come to naught.
Huh?
All right? And guess what? This counsel or this work wasn't of men. This counsel was of Yahweh Shem El Shai.
But if it be of the Most High, ye cannot overthrow it.
Mm-hmm.
Lest happily you be found even to fight against the Most High.
Lest happily you be found even to fight against the Most High. And that's what you were found out doing. You were fighting against Yahweh Shem El Shai. Alright? The being who's created existence, that's what you were found fighting against.
Your arms are too short, bro.
Yep. Way too short. Go ahead.
Matthew 21:44. And whosoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken.
That stone is Yahweh Shai, right? We're reading the book of Daniel in the second chapter. Go ahead.
But on whomsoever it fall, it will.